There is a time for the carrot and a time for the stick. Nigerian youth are halo due to my job, what I do every day, especially as a youth coach and a mentor. I've seen all manner of unbelievable things in the last 10 years, especially in our great country, Nigeria. So permit me to share a few of them with us as we celebrate our 59th birthday with a sad cake. Our youth watch all forms of international content, ranging from movies to social media, and that has shaped their expectations. But they've been unable to tone down their knowledge to fit into the space they are in, that is Nigeria. Hence, they complain, they are frustrated, and always yearning to be bored here. That is, go meet the grass that appears greener on the other side of Obodo Oyibo, the abroad. So they are internationally oriented but locally irrelevant. They know the names of the Kardashian family members who have no direct or indirect impact on their local government, but they don't care to know their ward councillors, local government chairman, House of Rep members, or senators, let alone governors, especially our youth, which fall in the class of millennials and partly Generation Z, both at home and abroad. With an entitlement mentality, they know how to complain but not to be good citizens. So our youth will prefer to dance shaku-shaku than to come out and vote on election day. Sowore is still behind bars despite the court order disobeyed by the federal government. Yet, what have Nigerian youth done? You hear people say, Shebi na him won't become president. Making use the political platform to do election revolution now, Nigerian senators are buying 5.5 billion naira worth of brand new cars, SUV for that matter. But many states can't pay 30,000 naira minimum wage. Yet, the Nigerian youth will shout, Twale Baba, Ombeji Loke Sekonle, when they come to our churches, our mosques, and our streets, just for the greedy politicians who drop crumbs for the agile and muscular but lazy youths. When people are being kidnapped, Nigerian youths will rather go and pray or do Africa insurance, Jujulonjebe, to protect himself and their family, neglecting others. When power-holding people decide to dance disco with our light, we go and buy generator. When Fashola boys don't fix our roads, we pray, sow seeds, to buy jeeps. After all, the scripture says, deep collect unto deep, but in this part of the world, it is jeep that collect unto jeep. When our public schools are short of teachers and infrastructures are dilapidated, we ensure that our children go to private schools. Many young Nigerians like Felado Toye, Banky W, Kingsley Mohalu contested in the last election. Nigerian youth preferred to vote for recycled old people just because of 5,000 naira and one tin of rice, tomatoes, shared by these old-time politicians. And they will say, now my own share of the stolen money be that at the collector. But in 2018, over 170 million votes were cast on Big Brother Niger show by the same Nigerian youth, 30 naira per SMS. That's 5.1 billion naira in revenue from SMS alone. When you as a youth start to defend fraudsters on social media, then it is now your suffering begins, NYSE. Why are Nigerian youth so obsessed with getting money? Why are these abominable practices seemingly on the increase? Things like baby factories for selling your own babies, eating of human and animal feces, using biological parents for rituals and drug abuse. It's like prostitution is now a career. All in the name of money. Where is our conscience? Where is the result of the churches and mosques we go every week? What is our Nigeria becoming? Nigerians, both young and old, we never be bored there to dance and teach their children. But they will never sing, but rather sing and dance to self-degrading music. If you don't get money, hide your face, and people will be screaming, chai, there is God, though, until we bear our body. That is, wake up from our act of irresponsibility, nothing changes. Remember, it is irresponsibility that makes a man become a liability. Bebo dear Nigerian youth.
I've learned to make body here today.
And I feel like
I've learned African insurance. I've learned African insurance.
I have to say thank you for that advocacy. It's very complete. And it's something that I share about because I also work a lot with young people. The biggest thing leadership, political leadership, should do, I listened to my president's address. I wasn't
inspired.
I wasn't inspired.
It was
one of the most important things that leadership does, as you said, is inspire.
Inspire, yeah.
You know, the youths are not inspired. And that sense, that cloud is very ominous. And that just leads them into this path where it's all negative because they feel that for me to survive, I've got to do whatever it takes, to survive. And then so we begin to find all of those things. I think we just need to find a way to dial back and bring inspiration back into this.
Okay, I guess, he's actually said what I wanted to say. Because I was thinking, you know, my own caveat, as Liberals was saying off air, was really to say, where did they learn this thing from? You know, they didn't just show up being hopeless by themselves. They're looking at us, and like he said, we are not looking for a social solution. We're looking for a self-solution, so to speak.
And
so everybody's looking for the easy way out. Yeah. Nobody's looking to fix it for society. Nobody's ready to sacrifice, you know, and say, look, instead of buying gen, let's all stand together and say this thing cannot continue. During the elections, it wasn't just the youths that went to vote for recycled politicians. It was, but yes, the youths constitute the largest. Mm-hmm. So if they stood up as one man and said, you know, which is why people like Mogalu may have felt betrayed because they were thinking and counting on the youths to come out in number and say, we'll get behind our man because they're 70% of the population. But instead, no show, you know. But like you said, when Big Brother Naija shows up, everybody rallies round.
Big Brother didn't just get the numbers they are getting today.
Yes.
They started from somewhere. And it now becomes, a way of taking out stress for young people.
Yes, it is.
You know, in a hopeless society, somebody gives, you know, a glimpse of hope. You're like, okay, this one will take my mind off crime, will take my mind off the street. I want to be in this place. Yes, escapism. Secondly, government, the purpose of government is security and welfare of the people. But a situation where there is absence of that, it will be to your turn to Israel. Like Fidel Castro once said, in a state of lawlessness, it becomes illegal to be law-abiding.
Wow.
And so what you have is a lawlessness and hopelessness right from the leader. You use the word, you climb and then you destroy the ladder.
Yeah.
And where the world is diversifying into a knowledge-based economy, what are we diversifying into? Nothing.
Nothing.
You had people who fought for June 12th. People like Moses Osakede as a youth leader died fighting for the actualization of June 12th. But these people are not celebrated. They are not
taught
about. Nobody remembers them. So why will anybody want to die again? Student unionism those days, actually you write from there and then become an advocate. But these days, you get into the university, all you're thinking of how to graduate quickly so that you can be making a living. But there is hope.
Yes,
and
I like
that. The hope is that this is the time
to start.
The politicians are regrouping.
Okay. Yeah.
And they're already talking about 2023.
They're meeting.
You won't see the Duro Toye, you won't see the Mogalu now until 6 months to election.
Mm.
Now is the time for them to begin to go round.
Or for us to get behind
them. Exactly, get behind them. Let them, you know, begin to sell their programs and tell people Obama started 4 years before the election, moving around, traveling. So let's continue to sensitize these people.
Yes.
You'll be shocked. And how amazing a Nigerian youth can turn out to be.
Thank you.
Uche?
No, I don't really have anything to add. You know, I think it was a great advocacy, and I really hope it speaks directly to the youth, you know, in the manner that you intended. You spoke in their language as well, which I thought was very important, you know. But, you know, your advocacy brought home Liberus's advocacy on mentorship. So it's the only way you can change that kind of mindset. It has to be through mentorship, through small groups, and then, you know, eventually it's like a virus that will then
which is why Shorey is looking like a mentor because he's standing in the face of opposition.
Yeah, exactly.
And still, you know,
standing strong.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah, I agree with you. Just like the Kennedy School of Leadership in Harvard, Dorin Fashola, something like that, I started in Lagos, of which I'm one of the mentors, so I can assure you that things are being done in the area of mentorship program. I don't tell you my own, Nigerian youth, not just Bebodie, but Besense here, you understand? So, on who will cry for Abba? Calm Talk TV says, the tax the government of Abia State is collecting every month from businesses in Abba is almost half the federal revenue show. Abia State receives from the federal government and yet nothing to show for it. Hmm. On the matter of capital punishment for kidnappers, Emeka Nweke says, death penalty for kidnappers, but meanwhile, the Nigerian government is granting amnesty and paying billions to terrorist groups like Boko Haram and Fulani militia herdsmen. Hmm. On the matter of our decadent educational sector, Tola Jai says, the other day I corrected someone on the platform that they don't share blood, but the word is share, okay? Some people came calling me a white man's slave. Honestly, the quality of our education is below zero. You need to hear and see the rubbish people talk and write. Much as we know, no one is perfect. There are some unpardonable mistakes. I hope it gets better. Okay, keep your comments coming in on our social media platforms, on Facebook, Plus TV Africa, hashtag The Advocate NG, on Twitter and Instagram at Plus TV, hashtag The Advocate NG. To catch up with previous broadcasts, go to www.plustvafrica.com/theadvocate. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, that is Plus TV Africa. Mm. After the break, Uche asserts that climate change is a hoax. Who are we to believe? You decide.